Okay.
And we are live in 3, 2, 1.
Now, okay,
and welcome
hello.
To the People Speak.
Yeah, and what else we have to know about People Speak and Talkaoke? You know what is Talkaoke?
No.
Okay. So Talkaoke is a free-for-all open platform for general chit-chatting and all conversations possible under the skies. So the big question is, you want to come and join us? It is Talkaoke, it's a free-form talk show. You can talk about whatever you like to talk.
Have you got a conversation?
We haven't got a conversation just yet. We just started the conversation. And the big question is, what is the conversation should be?
Stickies.
Okay, stickies. Before we get to stickies, we need to figure out who's who. What's your name?
My name is Louis Wassell.
Hello, Louis. What's your name?
I am Luca Carraro.
Hello. What's your name?
Hello, I'm Louis Walsh.
Oh, lots of Louis.
What's your name? I'm Catherine. Claire.
Mikey.
And I'm Shorty in the middle. So, all the Louis gathered around here. Hello, do you want to join us? This is Talkaoke. It's a free-form talk show. You can talk about whatever.
Stickies today.
Okay, we're talking about stickies.
Today we're talking about some things called stickies.
Okay, so what do we have to know about stickies?
I want to talk about something else.
He wants to talk about something else. What is it you would want to talk about?
I think we're going to be in trouble when Louis and Luca, and I don't know what this little one's called, when they get to be like in their 40s and 50s.
Because
because we're bringing up an apathetic generation.
Really? What?
Yeah.
Are you judging this? Come, join
yeah.
us.
Yeah, they're only interested in... Why
do you think it's going to be an apathetic?
I think we're just going to...
Look at the stickers. I think they'll be fine.
Sticky.
Yeah? Okay. Oh, look at the horse. Do you think the stickies will actually bring up like apathetic generation?
The stickies. We're talking about the stickies.
I don't know. We're talking about the generation.
I would like to know about the stickies because I got given 2 in Lidl and I didn't know what to do with them. So tell me what you like about stickies.
Okay, hello. What's your name?
Amanda.
Hello, Amanda. Yes. We are talking about stickies right now.
We've got 2.
Exactly. You've got 2. So bring it to the table.
Oh, no, we haven't got them with us, no.
So what do we have to know about stickies?
Can we talk about Westlife?
Westlife? Yeah, we can talk about Westlife if you tell me what's Westlife, because I have no idea.
Well, it was sad. It's all a bit sad, really. They broke up, I think, didn't they?
Really? Yeah. Who did?
Westlife.
What is Westlife?
They were a wonderful, wonderful boy band.
Ah, really?
Superb.
Okay. I've never heard about them.
They will really make you feel alive.
Really? Westlife? Does anyone do you know the band called Westlife? And did you know about the fact that they broke up?
Have they broken up?
I don't know. Well, apparently so. Do you know about Westlife?
No, but we're meant to be talking about stickies.
Okay, who wants to talk about Westlife? Who wants to talk about stickies? It's a democratic... Okay,
we could combine the subjects and are Westlife broken up because they're too into their stickies and they're spending too much time playing with their stickies?
Yeah. Do you know what's there? We're going to come to the stickies.
No. Westlife never used any stickies.
No?
No. They were good.
For fact.
Yes, no. They would never ever do anything like that.
Really? Are they like against stickies?
I don't want to make any more comment on this.
Okay. Come and join us. We're talking about stickies and Westlife.
About sticking with what?
We're sticking to stickies and Westlife.
Sticky!
I've got one on somewhere. I've got one on a sticky. I had a sticky.
And horses!
Yeah.
We're going to go to the pub anyway.
Right. See you in a bit. Stickies. Have you got stickies?
I think one of the problems, if you sit around this Talkaoke too long, you might start to feel a little hoarse.
Really? Here we go. Okay, what do you think that stickies make for you? I mean, what kind of difference that stickies brought to your life?
They are.
Come and join us. This is Talkaoke. We are talking about stickies and Westlife right now.
Sticky.
We don't exactly know how this conversation will actually evolve. I'm not exactly sure. Hello. Have you heard about Westlife?
Stickies are toys. Stickies are toys that you can stick around with. You can make them upside down.
Uh-huh.
Stick them to and each other.
Stick them to each other.
Yeah.
Or you can stick them
on glass, on plastic.
You can basically stick them on anything.
Okay.
I am now going to put a sticky on the screen.
Great. Mikey?
Don't put it on the camera, please. But you can put it on the TV screen if you want to.
Put it on the screen.
But this is the thing, is that these are the kind of toys which are not activating the children's imagination.
Really?
They're not actually. What about things like Lego and Meccano and stuff like that? And Play-Doh?
Yeah.
And plasticine, which...
Lego Minecraft,
that sounds like a good idea.
Minecraft.
Yeah. Minecraft's amazing, isn't it?
I don't know. I know nothing about Minecraft.
Oh,
I'm trying to
Minecraft.
Work out. Okay, is anyone... Okay, what's your name? We have to figure out what's your name.
Rose.
Rose. What's your name?
Louis Welsh.
And what's your name?
Francis.
Okay, it was a party call. We didn't collect all the names, but kind of. So, is any adult around the table knows what Minecraft really is about? Because it seems to be like that's a massive thing, yet I failed to gather any information about it, about the flag. There's a survival mode.
Well, what we want to do next year for Shambala is get loads of polystyrene blocks, like one meter. if we're invited back, we're not going to do Talkaoke. We're going to do real life Minecraft.
Yeah, but we have to figure out what's the non-real life Minecraft.
You don't know what Minecraft is.
Well, I don't, and I don't think anyone here.
It's a fairly boring computer game. That way, all you do is you just add the blocks together, and that's and it's quite tedious because you have to go and get the blocks.
Okay, but what's the goal?
The goal in Minecraft is to do anything. You can build, play with friends, play multiplayer servers, and kill enemies. You want to try and survive and survive without water and food.
Yeah, for how long? Is there an end to this game?
No, it's endless. Build massive structures.
What? And then can you see your... Hang on, Mikey. Can you see yourself playing this game in your whole life? Or do you think you will get to age 10, 15, 20, 50? Do you think
another 5 years, maybe.
For more 5 years?
Yeah.
How many more years have you got in Minecraft, inside you, for Minecraft?
Probably nearly all my life.
All your life? Okay, what about you? How many years?
I've just started.
You just started?
But okay, I still know a lot. Because my cousin plays it a lot.
Okay, right. We have to come to Mikey because he wants to say
that's the goal. The real goal of Minecraft is to occupy children.
That's the real goal.
It's to keep them busy. And that's why it'll be really good at Shambala, because you could keep the kids busy for the whole weekend. And then the adults can go and drink and have fun while the kids are busy building Minecraft blocks.
Right. Okay. What do you think about it? You obviously.
This is Fearcrow.
Yeah.
And he's already had to spend 2 weeks in rehab over Minecraft.
Uh-huh.
I mean, he's only 7 months old, and he's had 2 weeks of his life, his short life, in rehab over Minecraft. So no, I don't agree.
Okay. And how did the rehab look like?
Good. It's good. He's not touched it since. No, it's good.
Good.
Yeah.
But do you think it would be good for you if in festivals all kids would get busy with Minecraft and you could just get on with all the fun and drinking and dancing, whatever you got?
Yeah.
Minecraft.
Yeah, well, they will, but I mean, you need to be careful of people like him.
Yeah?
You know, because they can damage them.
Right, okay, let's come back to this. So, you kids, if there was a Minecraft, a real-life Minecraft playground here, would you play that, or would...
I play that every day, and I'll be on Talkaoke.
Okay.
On the people's
street. Half the day Minecraft, half the day Talkaoke.
Yeah.
Amazing. And do you think it would be like better in real life, or would it be better like on computers?
I would say 50-50.
50-50?
Yeah.
Okay, so one third real life Minecraft, one third virtual Minecraft, one third Talkaoke. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, right. But for me, as an adult, I still don't quite get how the real life Minecraft would look like.
Do you get how real life works in general? How does real life work? Maybe we should ask the kids.
Oh, I think it's too philosophical for this afternoon. Yeah, but you... Well, what?
I say it's quite hard with horses' hooves.
Yeah?
My God. To put the blocks together.
Okay, right, so... And why do you think that adults are not getting excited about this amazing thing called Minecraft? Is any adult playing? You play it.
Really good, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So,
I've got no life.
When did you start playing Minecraft?
Last year. When he was digging. Yes.
Like together?
And you have to dig and build, and you have to dig and dig and mine okay. for stuff.
What about you? Do you play computer games or Minecraft or anything?
I've never played on Minecraft.
And any other computer game which kind of keeps you busy these days?
The Sims.
Sims? Yes. Really? I thought Sims were like quite 90s. Do you still play it? Yeah. There's something wrong about saying it was 90s.
There was a guy yesterday on a Talkaoke table who had to play Angry Birds in order to go to the loo to do a number two.
Why is that?
I don't know exactly why, whether it's like whiling the time away or it just relaxes him, but Angry Birds has become part of that ritual of going to the toilet, yeah.
Okay. Now hang on, but before you go, you have to tell me how many years you think you have in yourself for Minecraft. Because it sounds forever.
No, probably, I don't know, 5 years.
5 more years. Okay.
Well, actually, it's going to go virtual and holographic next, isn't it? Microsoft have made like a holographic version.
Really?
Of Minecraft. So you can put these goggles on and then you play it. Is it holographically? Something like that, yeah. So probably 50 years.
Okay.
Yeah, you're inside the game.
Basically, you can already do that.
Say again?
You can already do that with stuff. And
what can you do with the new stuff, really?
You can make it so you put a screen to you have a screen to your head and some connected to your head or something, and then you can move your hands, and then you will move, and then you will move.
So you your basically, hands will move. Or is it like you're talking about like hand gesturing to do the Minecraft?
And on laptops and on computer, you can get a 3D version of Minecraft.
Really? What, is it 2D now?
Doesn't it depend on the individual to be able to choose for themselves? Some people enjoy that and they should be allowed to run with it if that's their cup of tea, and other people don't, and that's your own choice, and someone shouldn't be enforcing it on you going, oh, you can only do this or that, and if you like it then that's right, go for it, it suits your head.
Right.
No, it's not on the fence, it's not. It's on a...
Hang on.
It's on an individual basis.
Uh-huh.
So rather than going in blanket terms for everyone, it's going, well, what type of mind have you got? What do you enjoy doing?
Uh-huh.
And that's it.
Okay.
For me anyway, but yeah.
There's a lot of people who... Yeah, he was saying about, like, you know, if they're always on their computer, they're behind their keyboard. There's a lot of people that, like, have real problems, like, kind of interacting socially, and it's really... Like, they make loads of their friends that way. It's, like, a real way for, like... Because you've got, like, that kind of confidence, more confidence in yourself. So in that way, obviously, like, you know, very, very, very positive for a lot of people. As he says, it's literally, like, horses for courses.
Do you make lots of friends here since you've been to Shambala? Yeah. You are all talking about, yeah? Do you know any of your new friends' names or phone numbers?
Yeah, Luke, I don't know his phone number, a bloke.
Really?
Another lad's old Stanley as well, he was over there.
Okay.
Yeah, it's friendly people, just being friendly.
Yeah? So did you make friends?
Some mad kid called Lucian. Yeah,
okay.
He made a plasticine Captain America in our tent, which will live with me forever.
Yeah.
Is he in a Captain America suit?
I think he's...
Yeah, he's been wearing it for 3 days, apparently.
Maybe.
He won't take it off, yeah. It's mental.
Okay, and do you think you will keep her as a friend?
Huh?
You think she will be your friend forever?
No, you will forget
about the whole thing by tomorrow.
Well, we're not staying in touch. It'll be a bit weird, he's
all
like
right,
eight or
good.
Something.
Come back soon. Nice to meet you.
It's good working with you.
See you now.
You're better. Okay, let's leave them go. Wow, what a shame.
positive, happy things.
Bye. And the thing what I wanted to ask, I know it's, I'm not supposed to ask questions because that's not the game, but I'm changing the name of the game. Do you think when you are Shambala, you are more to yourself, or it is more like the external, unallowed, not really you who you are jumping into for a few days?
Well, yesterday, it was early in the day, early in the evening, and there was like this jazz band on, and it was that really free-form flamenco fusion kind of, it was just a mad mix of music, and I just really got up and I danced like an absolute lunatic.
Yeah.
I hadn't even had anything to drink yet.
Yeah.
But I just really liked the music. But you wouldn't do that in the pub, in your local pub. You know, you need to like have quite a few beers and whatever. So I think it is more your true self because you're just allowed to do whatever you want to do, as long as it doesn't involve injuring other people.
Well, what do you people think about it? Because obviously, the way you dress.
I know. I think you're definitely more true to yourself here because you have to kind of conform. You have to go to work. You have to go to school and like normal life. But
yeah.
Here, you can just do whatever you want. You can you can wear a suit here if you want, but it doesn't matter if you don't. That sort of thing. Yeah.
Okay. Then do you think? What's actually stopping people like basically wearing what they really like? Today.
But have you noticed everybody actually wears the same thing here? There's about 20,000 pairs of those cosmic leggings going around.
I'll
get my Shambala outfit together because I've got to look like everyone else, otherwise I'll stand out, you know. Like.
What does this mean? Does it mean that all suppressed inside little person is like a space missioner? Does it mean that? Or is like a.
No comment.
He hasn't said anything yet.
Yes, you're
Hello.
Right. Hello.
Hello,
what's your name?
Dara.
Dara, okay.
Hello.
Dara, I really like that you people sitting here are not actually one of those Lycra latex glitter. You better accept your little way.
Give us a few hours. Yeah,
give it 2 hours and we'll be Lycra enough, don't worry about it.
I don't know. How much
Someone
Lycra
got costs? A Lycra onesie for 90 fucking pounds?
Oh, wow.
Why would you spend that much money on a fucking bit of clothing?
Crazy.
Yeah, well, I don't think that's too much money to spend on clothing.
I've never spent that much money on any clothing ever.
He's very well dressed normally, as well.
I think you are. I really like your jacket looks expensive.
I think, I don't know about Lycra, but spandex has the same effect as, like a year's gym membership. So, it's actually, if you... Like 100 quid on a spandex suit is probably well spent because you could.
Look at that guy there. Just
yeah, I mean, yeah. You think he look? You think he looks like? And that is basically what he would look like after a year's gym.
Can I make an observation and ask you a question, please, mate? I'm bringing it all down and getting it serious and stuff, but actually I just realised, like, this is totally, like, a talking shop for people like to hear their own voice in it, right? Yeah. Have you, and there's only been men here since I've been here, is it just totally blokes all weekend just going, la, 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 la? Oh, that's it? Oh, good, I'm pleased.
Yeah, it's been mostly women talking about and being somewhat critical of the cross-dressing phenomenon.
Really?
But yeah, because they've been saying that they're not really dressing as real women, they're dressing as like sluts and whores, and it's not, and they're like, they're trying to be too macho with the way they're dressing up as women.
I take that quite personal.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Are you? Well, you said you taking out your cross-dressing.
Why should we? What? Like, you know, you can dress whatever you like. Why should it matter? That we, you know, I wasn't dressed particularly sluttily, but, you know, why does that matter? You know what I mean?
Well, what's your view on the cross-dressing thing? Do you think the men are just wearing very stereotypical slut costumes?
Oh, I really enjoyed it, actually. It's very, very nice. Yes, I got myself a lovely pink dress yesterday, and I thought I felt great. And actually,
okay,
do you know, I thought I will change my name.
Yeah.
I actually wanted everybody just to call me Derek.
Derek?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you mean yesterday or today?
Yesterday.
Yesterday.
While I was wearing a dress.
Where you were Derek in the little pink tutu?
Yes.
Okay, right. But were you wearing the rest of the outfit or today's outfit?
I've still got the pants.
Okay,
just
right.
The pants.
Right. Good.
Yes.
So you're coming back to cross-dressing. It's really amazing because yesterday you were like completely different and today again completely different. Like, unlike me, because I was wearing pretty much the same what I'm wearing today.
Hats.
Longer one, like trousers. Underwear. Yes, actually, yes. Yeah, we you know, if you don't take a shower, what's the point of changing your pants, right? I mean,
it's sort of like the closest you can get to taking a shower without having to queue up changing your pants, though.
Oh, is it?
And just got a quick run round with a wet wipe, and that, you know, do you know what I mean? Then you're good. Yeah, that's better than a shower in a way.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you people
not a fan of the wet wipe, believe it's nasty. It's that bad smell in it, that moisturisery smell. It's a bit, but some friend had some natural ones earlier. They were better.
What, natural wet wipes.
Yeah.
What a natural.
Wow.
Well, it had a massive list of ingredients that it didn't have in it.
Uh-huh.
Which I assume a normal one does have in it, like loads of chemicals, like polyphenol, blah, blah,
uh-huh.
Which terrifies you, obviously, but you don't know what it is. It's probably uh-huh. under a normal name. It's lime juice or something. Uh-huh. And, and then they just had aloe vera water,
uh-huh.
and they were a slightly stronger form of a tissue. So they're
really?
Robust enough to wipe around the pubes. Yeah.
Wow.
Are they bad for the environment?
Yeah, you can't recycle.
Oh.
Normal wet wipes are normally quite unrecyclable, but...
Some of them are flushable. They're like made out of paper with other shit in there, with like cotton in it and stuff.
Yeah, I think the posh ones are recyclable.
The posh ones work, yeah.
Hi.
The sun. What do you
Hello. Hello, sun. Come and just kind of give us some of your rays. we are talking about lots of things. the hot topic around the table is posh wet wipes.
Yeah. Yeah. No, do not put them in the compost loo.
Yeah. You know everything. Hello, sun.
Hello.
Who you are?
I'm Venus.
You're Venus. Okay, well, who you are? Actually, I didn't ask you who you are.
Mr. Sandman.
What's fun man?
Sand.
Fun, okay.
Man.
Good. Okay, yep.
They the drawings? No, I can't remember. Okay,
right. So, this is Talkaoke. This is Talkaoke. It's a free-form talk show, meaning you can talk about whatever you like to talk about. So far, we've been talking about virtual reality, real reality, wet vibes, Jeremy Corbyn, home education, and Jazz Weekend. Is it you? Is it real you as you are, or it is the person you are now is not a real you kind of question? It's complicated. What would you like?
When I come through the gate of Shambala, I just think, thank God.
Thank God.
Normality. For once.
When you arrive.
Say again?
Is that when you leave or when you arrive that you feel that?
It's definitely when I arrive.
When you arrive?
Yeah.
And then how does it compare with the other 51 weeks of the year?
How does Shambala compare with it?
Yeah, I mean, it must be like a tough job to, you know, to bring the rest of the year to the same level, no?
This weekend for me is just, it's normality to its absolute.
Okay.
To be with Fred, was it Fred?
Derek.
Oh, Derek.
No, she was Derek yesterday.
He's changed his name. I'm sure you said Fred. Okay,
no,
Derek.
No. Derek was yesterday when she was wearing...
Called Derek. And today I'm a man called Sandman. Sandman.
Sandman. Okay, yeah, Sandman. Yeah. Okay. Like Enter Sandman. Great.
What's your name?
My name is Joseph.
Hello, Joseph.
And where were we?
Strong biblical name. What does Joseph do in the Bible again?
Oh, I don't know. Probably saves all the animals or something like this. I don't know.
He has a Technicolor dream coat and he thinks
I don't know.
Will do.
What was it? Does anyone know what the Technicolor dream coat is about?
He's the illegitimate son of the father of Jesus, isn't he?
We all
know that. Yeah, he's like, poor guy. He like couldn't get it on and like with Mary and that. And then God has his kid for him and he's like, ugh.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I never heard this story.
And everyone's like, alright, you know, like, but he's a bit of a non-character in the Bible, really, the poor man who didn't have a kid.
You know,
really.
Well, you know, this is maybe that's my mission, maybe that's why I'm here, I will be...
Actually, he does go on to have a load more children, so the Virgin... Yeah, the Virgin Mary then stops being a virgin after being a virgin, gets it on with Joseph, had loads of children, and then carry on from there.
Uh-huh.
He was a good carpenter as well.
Uh-huh.
Are you good with wood? Are you a carpenter?
He built an ark. He built an ark as a carpenter.
Are you sure? Is that the same tool, therefore? No, okay.
Yeah, why would you not get the carpenters to build the ark?
Come on. Hang on. Behave. Right order. Well, who built the ark?
Noah. Come on, it's
okay,
Noah.
Okay, apparently it was someone else who built the ark.
See, that's bullshit. Noah isn't even a carpenter.
Hang on.
He wouldn't know what he was doing. You've got that wrong.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where are you, the star of Bethlehem, Venus? You might have been.
I know the star of Bethlehem personally.
I think it was a comet.
It's a very, very close personal friend.
Supernova.
I thought it was a comet as well. Halley's Comet. Wasn't it Halley's Comet? Supernova.
I have no idea about all this.
Was it a champagne supernova?
No idea. So it was really interesting what you said. Oh, hi. Hello. What's your name?
Hi, Lucy.
Hello, Lucy. Hey. Nice to have you here. Come back, Vivi.
I just want to ask the sun what she thinks of solar panels. Are you into solar panels, or is that using your energy unwisely or wisely, or what?
It's a tough one, isn't it? What do you think about solar panels?
It's very tiring.
Yeah.
However, I think it's a good use of my energy.
Is it?
Do you get a lot of spots? What do you do when you get spots? Do you just let them go?
Hang on.
You can put a bit of
sunscreen.
Solar Clearasil.
No, I was thinking more like a moisturiser.
Moisturiser, more like a sunscreen kind of thing, right?
What? I was just wondering if the sun is suffering from burnout, actually.
Yeah, no, you're not suffering from burnout. You're never going to burn out, right?
Are you off to bed soon?
4 hours. Four hours, yeah. A little bit of light left in me.
It's a very good idea, olive oil. Okay, where are we going to take this conversation? You want to talk about the sun? You want to talk about solar panels? You want to talk about a drink? You want to talk about Jeremy Corbyn, which I don't want to talk about?
I actually don't think Cherry Coke should be classed as a soft drink.
Ah, really?
For the simple reason, it is. Yeah. It's just bastardizing.
Yeah.
Cherries.
Yeah.
And Coke.
Really?
Oh, yes. Sunny D is the devil's spunk, apparently.
Why is that?
Sunny D.
What is
devil's
Sunny
spunk?
D? I have
horrible.
No idea what you're talking about. Where was the Sunny D?
Sunny
D. I came from a different planet, I don't know.
Sunny D is supposed to be juice. Yeah, Sunny Delight.
Hang on, you don't have to shout. I can only give you the microphone, so you don't have to shout.
I remember the day when Sunny D was away. Well, it was.
Can I ask the sun what she thinks of Sunny D? Do you personally endorse Sunny Delight?
Yes. Sunny D. No,
it's an imposter. Solero's all the way for me.
Solero's. Right. Any other solar-related questions? This is your big chance. Yeah.
Are you wearing solar flares?
I'm wearing a very skin tight lycra ensemble piece. Wasn't my choice, but I'm going with it.
Okay, don't hold back. Maybe you can also have Venus related questions now.
Pants.
You're wearing pants.
Just, yeah. Just pants.
Okay. So maybe you could all pick one of your favorite planets. Which planet are you then? Your Sun, your Venus.
I don't know.
You don't know.
Uranus,
very good. What's your planet?
My favorite planet.
What's your favorite planet?
Oh,
Okay, okay.
Uranus.
Uranus, yeah, okay. Yeah. Earth.
Yeah, I'm an Earth.
You're an Earth. Yeah. What about you?
Mars.
Mars, okay. Favourite planet?
Men are from Mars, women are from Venus, and pop psychology is from Uranus.
Okay.
Can I take Uranus?
Why are Uranus so widely popular? I don't
it's
get it.
It's because it's a gaseous planet.
And we have missed out on Saturn's rings, haven't we?
Yeah.
But that's the best. It's the most beautiful planet, isn't it? Saturn with those rings. And I found out quite recently why they're in a flat level.
Yeah.
It's quite weird, isn't it? Like, why the hell would they... Well, I don't know if I want to bore you with a long, lengthy explanation as to how it goes.
Well, hang on. Let me just get the final thought from the Sun and Venus before they depart.
Yeah, don't come back to me.
And maybe I might be not. Any final thoughts?
Venus is obviously the best planet.
Yeah.
But also, I'm now going to go and assemble the other planets, and we'll be back.
Are you?
Yeah.
Video entire
for the planetarium chat.
Oh my God.
The other planets. We've got to go and find.
Final thoughts. Come back.
I just like to leave him saying, Jez, we can.
Okay.
Yeah, man, Jez, we fucking can.
Jez, we can. Thank you. Right, people, we have some free seats here. Come and join us. This is Talkaoke. It's a free-form talk show. You can talk about whatever you like, whenever you like.
I just want to explain, because some people didn't know who Jez was. And actually, earlier on, no one knew half of people didn't know who Jez was. And that's Jeremy Corbyn. He's a guy that looks like a CDT teacher, but he's actually the new hope for Britain.
Right, okay. We are not talking about Jeremy Corbyn, are we?
Well, I just wanted to explain. Someone said, who's Jez? Jez we can. That's who Jez is.
Right, what's your name?
I'm Tim.
Hello, Tim.
A lot of people would call me Tim the Twat. But on the subject of Jez, first of all, most people I meet, I don't know their nickname straight away. So when someone says Jez, I don't know his name's Jeremy. I just know someone's calling him Jez.
Right.
And
the moral of the story is...
The moral of the story is new hope for England, a different direction, and maybe a slight slant in the right angle that we're hoping to head towards, but a new direction? Not really.
So what do we need for a new direction? Do we need something a little bit more radical?
Maybe we do. Yeah. Maybe we don't. Maybe that's the whole fucking fun of it.
Okay. Maybe we don't need any direction. Hello, what's your name?
Nicole.
Hello, Nicole. Hello. Nice to have you. This is Talkaoke. As I said, it's a free-form talk show. What would you like to talk about? We can talk about whatever
fish.
You like. Fish. Okay. Who's up for fish? Fish.
As a former marine biologist, I totally support the fish motion.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so what were you just...
As a marine biologist, I stick with him.
Which aspect of the fish you are interested in most? And I'm coming back to you.
Fried or grilled?
Fried or grilled, okay. Fried or grilled?
Controversial or not, guess the fish. Starting now, until you guess it, this does not end.
Very good.
That's a cod question, if ever I've heard one.
Right.
That's a cod answer as well.
Good answer.
Two birds sitting on a perch, and one turns to the other and says, "Do you smell fish?"
Right. Okay, you started it, and now they're like fish puns and pun fishes are flying
all over the place. Two snowmen standing in a field. The one says to the other, "Can you smell carrot?"
What did the dyslexic pimp buy? A warehouse.
Two monkeys in a bath. Whatever everyone listening. Had some cold.
Very good. Okay, people, we kind of went into like a joke-telling mode. We have two more seats for the best jokes in town. Come on, people. Glitter, anyone with glitter is allowed.
If you don't know what introspection is, you need to take a long, hard look at yourself.
That wasn't funny. There you go.
What do you call a raver in a bank? Safe.
I don't think it was a very. Maybe it was, we were just not, I'm not clever enough.
Seal walked into a club.
Yeah.
Like you, I find it funny.
Okay. Sorry. Why is it wrong to say I run into the campsite? It should be I ran into the campsite because it's past tense. Apologies to the people who've heard that before.
Right. Okay, more jokes.
We haven't done the fish. Go on, what was it?
I'm addicted to brake fluid. My name's Tim, but I can stop anytime I like.
Hilarious. Thank you very much. Come on, join us. It's Talkaoke. Nobody used to be like, normally it's a talk show, but this is not a talk show now. It's more like a joke show.
A set of jump leads go into a bar and they say, go have a pint. The barman goes, I'll serve you, but don't start anything.
Right. Very good. What's your name?
Hi. Did you say what's my name?
I did say what's your name,
okay,
and it wasn't a joke.
My name's Bernie.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to the table. Okay. So basically, you can tell a joke, or you can talk about something, whatever.
Okay. I'll tell a joke.
Okay, tell a joke.
A man walks.
Are you going? Okay, fine. Thank you very much. Final thoughts. Hang on. I have to ask, what's your final thoughts before you go?
I just want to know what the fuck your brain is like at the end of this day, because you must be the most scrambled, like, ah! It must be amazing. You must have the worst take on humanity ever.
Thank you very much. What's your joke?
Okay, a man walks into a doctor's surgery.
Yeah.
A chip in his ear and a sausage up his nose.
Uh-huh.
Doctor says, I know what your problem is.
What's your problem is?
You're not eating properly.
Brilliant. Thank you. So, okay, so this is Talkaoke. Come people, come a bit closer. We have to fill up all these chairs, otherwise this is not a proper chat show. Come sit down with us. So, after the jokes and after the fish, what are we going to talk about?
Yes, the fish is still open, guys.
The fish is open, yes, but we yes, but unless you is there something what you would like to talk about? Because it's, you can talk about it whatever you like, and we just spin it around. He always wants.
I was just going to say, if you haven't got anything to talk about, you can always revert back to guess the fish. So it's maybe something to park.
Well, the thing is, the fish started off well, yeah, but then we all went to jokes, and I'm like, not from.
I know,
this
that's the problem with the jokes. Once you get into the jokes, you can't get out of the jokes.
I know, and I then don't you get worse any and worse.
It's a spiral of it's a spiral because you just get worse and worse jokes as you go along.
And then what happens at the end?
You go into the black hole.
Black hole of jokes,
yeah. Okay, here's one. I don't think people are telling jokes anymore because they're doing visual jokes.
Yeah.
Like, it's all online, it's all on Facebook, so it's visual jokes. And people don't tell verbal jokes anymore.
Yeah.
Like, my supply of jokes
is people actually around here.
Yeah, but they're all really old ones. My supply of jokes has dried up because people are not thinking of new jokes.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Well,
like, the joke that won the Edinburgh Festival this year was rubbish, and it wasn't a new joke. I've deleted... Oh, you've got a joke. Yeah?
Knock, knock.
Ah, this is...
Doctor. You said it!
Yes, an oldie but a goodie.
Well, if you ask me, this is the black hole of jokes, getting to the knock-knock jokes. That's hell. Okay, what was
the winner of the Edinburgh Festival's joke of the year?
What was it?
I deleted all the German numbers from my phone. It's hands-free.
Brilliant.
It's rubbish.
Brilliant. Hands-free.
No, knock, knock.
Right, okay, up at the fish. And up at the jokes.
Yeah, the jokes.
What do you want to talk about? Oh yeah, that was a good one. Why do you think people are like not creating? Do you think there is enough joke coming into the stream? Or you agree with Mikey, who thinks that it's like all about cats and cat jokes and visual jokes? Come sit down and tell me what you think about it.
Lobster walks into a bar.
No. We've got a serious
talk about. So,
no, it's we went to the from joke mode to talk mode. You just missed that boat. Just but there will be a joke session at 5:30 again.
Right. Serious stuff.
This is very serious. It upset me a lot. This is where society has come to. One Direction split up.
Oh,
and
right.
There is a counselling hotline. Discuss.
Oh, my God. I don't know. I only heard about Westfield breaking up.
This is nothing new. Beatlemania in the 60s, it's amplified due to the internet, but at the same sort of teen hysteria has been happening for 50 years. Take that split up when I was, what, 9, and that was a tragedy.
Yeah.
This is nothing new. This...
Hang on.
Your grief was to an organised platform for you to vent your grief and set up by a charity or some kind of group that feel like they were doing the better good for people.
Was there any support
How
for
is
you?
That any different from a football team who loses the World Cup or the FA Cup and their fans pouring out disaster? Why do we demean young girls for their passions?
Why?
I'm not saying that they do, but I'm saying that there's not a phone line, as you were saying, a phone line set up specifically to call. Everyone can grieve over whatever they want to grieve over, but a phone line, for fuck's sake, come on.
Why not? Why like new solutions could be useful,
actually,
right?
I think people form attachments to different things for different reasons, and
yeah.
A pop group or a football team is actually symbolic of
yeah.
some other need they have in their lives.
Yeah.
So when they lose that, uh-huh. they can be genuinely kind of grief-stricken, and actually
yeah.
that might be a symptom of some other underlying kind of emotional issues that they need to sort out. And actually, counselling, therefore, for people who are distressed,
yeah.
is a good thing.
Yeah, they think it's a fun phone line.
You could potentially have the same phone line for One Direction as for West Ham supporters, for example.
Why? Yeah, West Ham is still kicking.
Yeah, no, but I mean, you know, what happened when, when Joe Cole left West Ham United, you know what I mean? It was a big problem. I agree with that point. Like, people project all of their hopes and dreams either onto One Direction, West Ham United, or some kind of weird sustainability company or something like that, you know.
Uh-huh.
Like, whatever it is, people are projecting their hopes, their dreams, their fears, and when that doesn't work,
they need
someone to talk to.
And then if you can't...
doesn't matter who, it can be the same phone line. It doesn't need to be a different phone line.
Okay, so is it a One Direction phone line, or is it like a general phone line?
What I'm concerned about, though, is something that jumps up that quickly after such a minor Western first world problem as One Direction splitting up, is that who is it actually getting a resolve out of it? Is it the cunt on the end of the phone who's like trying to resolve the problems for the screaming fan, or is it actually the screaming fan who needs to phone up to solve some... Sorry.
Valid question. What's the answer?
I don't know if I can really fully answer that question, but I put out the idea that actually it is, as you were saying, kind of a concept that's like a bigger thing, and it's our like human nature to be kind of a, you know, a group, and you define yourself by what you're not.
Yeah.
So if you are the One Direction fans, everyone else is the other people, and if suddenly that comes apart, regardless of whether it's, you know, a crappy band like One Direction, or because, you know, you've all lived in the same village for many generations,
uh-huh.
or because you're from the same country when you're abroad,
right.
UK people.
So you just basically, oh come on, well, sit down please, and I will listen to you. I don't think it was very interesting. So basically, when the thing what you attach to the most just disappears, what's left for you? But I don't know what's for me. I'm not really attached to things. Maybe it, do you have like a strong? Well, I don't think I have like. But it's not about me really. What is it you attach to? Like the most strongly about your family and friends and all that nice things in life, which is like.
I don't know. I think maybe I don't have something like One Direction, but I would say I would know what
it was when
it all came apart.
Hang on, give me a
stickleback. It was a stickleback. Guess the fish.
Is that because you're a fan of Nickelback?
Must be. Right, okay, going back to what you are connected to the most. Is it your phone? Is it your fish? Is it your favourite band?
She didn't finish talking.
That's true. Very good observation.
I can't remember what I was saying.
You can't remember.
I have an older
sister. You were saying something along the lines of what you are,
so I'm
what
very
you are,
aware that
the deep
someone can jump in, and I'm used to just like letting it go. I think that's the kind of thing when you've got an older sibling.
Uh-huh.
You kind of learn to just, if someone talks over you, you're just like,
whatever.
So it's gone, I'm afraid. I don't think I could ever tell
okay,
you.
Okay, fine. Okay, well, what is it you connected to the most?
Just a comment I was going to make about the kind of need for kind of counselling. In 1997, when Diana was killed, we had a massive outpouring. Now, people weren't actually attached to Diana, the Princess of Wales, but she symbolised some aspect of their grief that they couldn't relate to in their ordinary lives, but her dying gave them a kind of reason to mourn and feel grief and express that.
Uh-huh.
And actually One Direction and the need for kind of emotional support is there for all of us, you know, in all different circumstances.
Okay, so it is more about mourning about something. It doesn't really matter who the actual thing you're mourning.
Well, it's interesting. This reminds earlier about 4 years earlier on. No, 4 hours earlier on, actually. It feels like 4 years. Somebody was saying, oh, you know, consumer society tells us we're not good enough. Continually says we're not good enough. We're not smart enough. We're not rich enough. We're not sexy enough. And then when something like that, Diana dying, it's like, oh, you can actually, it's something that you can actually, as a whole society, kind of like have this kind of catharsis, this expression of like sadness.
Yeah.
But maybe it comes from this kind of sense of like never being good enough.
Oh, wow. That's quite a curveball, at least for me. I need to have your final thought or reaction on what Mikey just said.
I can give you a joke.
Give me a joke.
It's a brand new one.
Okay, that's
so
what we need.
It could argue your point that jokes are still alive. Yes. It's just how you put them together. So what's similar about a newborn puppy and a slice of bread? They both go furry after a few weeks.
Woo!
That's my end.
That's very good. It's very good. Keep it going.
That reminds me of how do you make
No. We're not going back to jokes.
You're like a terrible.
Thank you very much, Mikey.
What's worse than finding half a maggot in your apple?
No
idea. Holocaust.
Brilliant. Mikey, you know what? Why don't you just jump in the middle and deal with all these funny people? So people, today will be a little change of hands.
Well, let's just have a massive round of applause for Joseph. A bigger one than that, come on. He's been, as the man said, he has to listen to all these people's crazy stuff. And it does, being a Talkaoke host myself, it does. It affects your head. It affects your mind. So we're going to keep this going. There's been a lot of stuff, a lot of conjecture, a lot of ins and outs of people to meet. I'm just going to just quickly get some names and just reintroduce this concept of Talkaoke. It's a free-form talk show. Everyone's welcome to come and sit down on the table of chat and talk about whatever. So let's just get some names. My name's Mikey. What's your name?
My name's Renata. It's nice to meet you, Mikey.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's Ross.
I'm Bernie.
I'm
Aidy.
Okay, so come and sit down. You can take your cigarette. Of course you can. This table is beer-proof and fag-proof. Anyway, so come and have a seat. Do we need a new subject? Do we want to carry on?
On the Diana thing and the thing that we are tribal people. Yeah. So we start off with our family, and then we have our town, and then we have our country.
Yeah.
And we like to join together in groups. That's what we're doing here today. Yeah. So we like to be part of something that's bigger than ourselves, because we are tribal.
Okay, so it's part of a kind of It's part of a kind of tribal mentality. Do people agree with that? Do people agree with that? Is it part of a tribal? Are we part of a tribe?
Yeah, we all need to belong, and we are not individuals by ourselves. Life becomes pretty kind of sad and limited if we all are just on our own. So we need connections and relationships and a sense of community and a sense of belonging to give us a sense of connection and feedback and validation and, a sense of being in the world.
So what tribe are you part of then?
Oh, Shambala tribe this weekend.
So this is a kind of tribal event. Do people agree with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So we're kind of like... So this is kind of like a gathering of the tribe.
come and have a seat. I've managed to get my way in the middle, Mr. Stickleback. So, he's Nickelback. Yeah, Stickleback, Nickelback. Are we all part of a tribe?
Why did the baker's hands smell? Because he needed a poo.
Okay, fair enough. So anyway, but we're part of this tribe. Do you feel part of the Shambala tribe? Is this a yearly gathering of the tribes?
Why can't we say jokes?
You can't say jokes.
All right, I wanted to say this when I first sat down.
Okay.
Lobster walks into a bar. Barman says, "Oh, I can't serve you." Lobster says, "Why not?" "Well, because last night you're giving it all this."
Okay. I thought he was giving it all that. Yeah. But, okay. So they've got the lobster, the famous lobster walks into a jar, walks into a bar. Oh, ouch.
Original question.
Yeah. What was the original question?
Whether or not the tribe of Shambala feels an all-encompassing, welcoming blanket.
Yeah.
I think that, you know, no.
No?
Because...
You don't think...
It's a false blanket, a blanket that we'll accept. I'm more than happy to know that I'll put on my calendar, right, that week I'm going to go to Shambala, and I know I'm going to get smothered with love.
Yeah.
But the love, you know, everyone's booked that week of love into their calendar. So just because you've booked a week of love into your calendar, does that mean that it's instinctive, or it's just like, I'll have to put that week of love aside and then I'll get really lovey on that week?
Okay.
Which I feel, and I love, don't get me wrong, but it's
planned love. It's planned love, it's not spontaneous love. What are people... Is Shambala a tribe, or is it a false blanket of planned love, i.e. not spontaneous? That's what Stickhook... So come and get involved in this. We're having a kind of debate. Well, we're trying to, I suppose. We've got, what's your name again?
Sadie. I'd just like to say the blanket's quite expensive, though.
Yeah.
Quite an expensive blanket.
Okay, so it's not... So you need to pay to be part of this
You
tribe.
Have to be... Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Okay. Okay, is Shambala a tribe, or is it just a sham?
It's a festival.
Yeah? Do you feel part of the tribe?
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, what do you think this tribe, what defines the tribe?
I'm not really sure, because this is only my second year at Shambala.
Okay, so you're picking up the pieces. Okay.
And I've got a joke.
Okay. Yeah, go on then.
I'll
come back to you when you can remember it. So what do people think? Is it a tribe? What defines the tribe? Have you got something to say? Is it a false blanket of love?
What I'd like to say about Shambala is I really like the mix of people and the people that turn up, because it's really like there's a great range of ages and sort of like there are some people like totally on the mash, and there's some people getting up early to do like the kind of healing field thing, and I really like that about Shambala. It's so broad.
Where do you fall on that spectrum?
Somewhere in between, perhaps.
Okay. I'm not going to make any comment about that. Do people agree with that? That it's all inclusive? Stay involved.
What festival did the people speak go to?
I don't know.
Shambala.
Okay. Okay, but what's the punchline? What's the punchline? That's just a fact. It's not a joke.
Did you ask what festival sheep go to? And was it Shambala?
There we go. We've workshopped the joke. Shambala. Shambala. Okay, right. So what are people talking about? Give us a final thought or initial thought even.
It can't be a tribe because anybody can come.
So that means it's not a tribe.
No, it's a blanket.
It's more of a blanket. Yeah. Is it a false blanket?
Why would it be false?
Because not everyone is accepted. You have to pay the money to get in. And it's too planned because you're not just doing it spontaneously. You don't just happen across Shambala. You put it into your calendar on iCal or Google Calendar.
Happen. It could be like a fin blanket.
Okay,
Shambala
so
it's a fin blanket.
It's a blanket. It's like a... It's like a thin blanket or one of those blankets with lots of tiny little holes in.
I think that's like just an issue about festivals, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's not Shambala, you know. That's like, festivals are that weird, like, oh, let's live in the society that we all want to be in, you know. Like, we're all kind of open-minded people doing things that, you know, are perhaps frowned upon in real life society. And we're creating society where we can have fun and do interesting things. But when you take away from that, then it sort of becomes a bit confusing, doesn't
it? What do you think, like, would be frowned upon the most in this festival? I mean, what were, like, something like...
Paedophilia? There's one.
Okay, I mean, is that going on in the festival?
That's got to be high up there. He's right.
No, what I mean is, what do you think, say someone like Michael Gove or someone like that,
if they... He looks far too clean to be a proper person.
Okay.
Like,
I've got another Jake.
Oh, yeah?
I'm not allowed to be here.
Knock, knock.
Yeah, who's there?
Mikey.
Mikey who?
Don't you know yourself?
Fair enough, it's coming there. All right, okay, so... we're talking about Shambala. Is it a tribe? Is it a false blanket? Is it a blanket with holes in it? Are people doing things that are frowned upon by the real world here in the festival? Or not really? Come and join in. Come and join in, have a chat. We'll have another quick round of names. What's your name?
Amy.
And?
You know me.
I know, but we're doing a round of names.
What's your question?
What's your name?
I was cleaning up here.
Okay, well, come back to you. What's your name?
Catherine.
Ren.
And?
Ross.
Lily.
Bernie.
And Bernie. Come and sit down. I'm trying to work out what animal you are, but what animal are you?
I'm a wolf.
You're a wolf. Scary. And?
Jack.
And what's your name?
Wolfie.
Okay, so what are we talking about, Shambala? Is it... Are the things going on? What's your name?
Lily.
Are the things that are happening in Shambala really frowned upon? That's what people are saying. That's why it can't be done outside in the outside world. But do people agree with that?
I think it depends on your perception of what's right and what's wrong in the outside world.
Okay.
But yeah.
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 Where is this? Maybe this is the outside world.
Yeah, this is the outside world, though.
Okay. All right, would this be frowned upon in the inside world? I don't know what's the inside. I don't know. It's not my job to have the facts. It's my job to pass the microphone around.
I think it's not frowned upon. It's just you might get laughed at, I guess.
Okay.
This is a kind of like form of licensed craziness.
Okay, so people maybe are worried about getting laughed at, but they're not laughed at here. Certainly not Louis with his jokes, and it's not laughed at. But are people worried about being laughed at? Is that what it is? Do you wear a wolf costume out and about wherever you're from?
No, I don't, but I think people are a bit iffy about it in the real world, but here it's just like no one gives...
Okay, so people do disapprove of a wolf costume?
I think they would, yeah. Some people do, like, oh, they're doing that's not right, but actually it's just normality.
Okay. What, have you got any view on this?
Yes.
What is it?
I do.
What is the view?
Well, I guess it's a safe space, really. Like, you can do literally anything you want. I mean, obviously within reason.
Yeah.
Don't murder a person at Shambala.
Yeah.
That's gonna kill the vibe. But
okay.
Like, I don't know. Just it's nice to like break the rules of society.
I like this idea that it's a safe space. That's a nice point. Is it safe? Do people feel safe here? Is that because all weekend people have been going, oh, Shambala, why can't we do this in the rest of the world, in a normal, but no one's mentioned the idea of a safe space yet, that it's safe to just to do anything. Do people agree with this? What's your name again?
Jack.
With Jack's idea.
I think it's the part of being surrounded by people that are all like creative and doing sort of crazy things. So you're part of like this being.
You're part of a creative. Yeah, a creative storm.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So you're kind of caught up in a creative storm. Are you caught up in a creative storm? Come and sit down. Come and rest your stormy legs on the table of chat. Are you gonna? What's going on in there?
Watch it from here.
Place of war.
I can't hear from over there, but it sounds good.
A Venezuelan band.
Okay, it sounds good. I don't know. Maybe.
Louis, camera back here. Thank you.
I think it's a safe space now for what you would class as normal people. Because I grew up in the, a long time ago, and I used to go to the free festivals like Stonehenge,
right,
and places like that. And we would be frowned upon as being a bit weird, out from outside society. In fact, you know, Thatcher's Britain did view us with distaste,
right,
and put the police on us at the time. So now people can be can pay a lot of money, and they can do crazy things that once were frowned upon by the authorities.
Right.
So yeah, it's a freedom now.
Do you think the authorities still frown upon it, or do you think they've still got the same view as Margaret Thatcher had then?
I don't think so now, because it's contained, and they know what we're up to, what we're going to do. It's in an environment where we can't escape, and we're not really going to subvert society by doing whatever we're doing.
Okay.
Which was the view in the past, which was not true.
Okay.
It was just a group of like-minded people having fun, but it wasn't seen like that in those days. It is now.
Okay.
When you said Stonehenge, do you mean Glastonbury?
No.
No, is that a different festival?
Stonehenge was actually at the Stonehenge Monument.
And what happened there?
Stonehenge is not near Glastonbury, no.
Tell us what happened at the Stonehenge Festival, for the sake of Louis.
The Stonehenge Festival ran for many, many years. And then in 1980, I'm trying to think which year it was, 83, 84?
I think it was 85, because it was 30 years.
I'm trying to think, it's a long time ago. And he's gone now, so I don't need to explain it.
No, he's on the camera.
Oh, he's on the camera.
Yeah.
Oh, I see, right. And a nasty lady in power didn't like the hippies, so she sent a lot of police and army people to go and beat them up, basically, is what happened.
But they were a bit like the police rave unit, but real.
Margaret Thatcher, milk bottle snatcher.
Okay. I sort of feel like we're sort of coming to a natural end, but maybe let's get some final thoughts from people, so come and get involved.
Yeah. I find that having been to like a few festivals now, I feel more prepared to go out into the real world and do dumb shit.
Yeah.
I've done it before in practice.
This is almost like a laboratory of doing dumb shit.
And then you can go out into the real world and do it properly and scare people and make them cross the road.
Yeah. Okay. So what kind? Can you tell us what sort of dumb shit?
I don't know. Just dressing in wavy garments.
Right. I see.
That kind of. It's obviously it's no revolution.
So it gives you confidence.
It's nothing huge. It's just nice to be slightly varied from the general crowd.
Right. Yeah.
And I had something else to say. What was it? What was I going to say?
Well, we were talking about Stonehenge and Margaret Thatcher. Give us a final thought before you go. Yes, you. Sorry, I've just.
Final thought.
Give us a final thought.
I think festivals are really great.
Okay. all of them? All just as great as each other?
No, I've been to some really shit ones, but this one's really great.
Okay.
It's a group mentality. When you've got a load of people around you doing the same thing, you feel more like ready to join in. Like Jonathan Kay doing his Daily Fool in there. You go around as a mob and just cause havoc. You're not going to do it on your own because, I don't know, whatever, insecurities. But if you've got other people supporting you and doing it with you, then obviously.
Anyway. Yeah. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. That totally makes sense. I'm just wondering, you still need one person to start it off, don't you, to actually be the first person. I don't know if Shambala just started with one person doing crazy stuff, and if many, many years ago. I don't really know the history. But anyway, let's get some final thoughts, because I think we have now got to the point of the parade, and I'm supposed to be the colour green in a rainbow, as you can probably imagine. So let's maybe just get some final thoughts. Any final thoughts? Catherine, have you got a final thought?
Yeah. Well, there is no right or wrong answer to anything. All conversation is void, because I can't agree with anything someone says, and I can't disagree with anything anyone says, because we're holding each other to standards that are all made up. Everything is made up. You are made up, I'm made up, this microphone's made up, and we're only holding each other to standards that are made up because other people hold us to standards that are made up. So when I disagree with an opinion someone has, or I agree with an opinion someone has, I'm only playing the part of playing this game that everything is made up. And that's it. So I can't agree or disagree with anything. It's all a hazard. It all doesn't make sense. Conversation is void. End of.
Okay. Yep.
The only thing that is real is atoms. Everything else is opinion.
Okay. Would you rather live in the world of atoms or the world of opinions?
I'm learning to enjoy the world of opinion, but you've got to use it to your own needs.
Okay. Final thought?
Higgs boson particle.
Okay.
Go and find your rainbow.
Yeah, the God particle.
Are you in tomorrow?
No, this is it. This is it. We are now going to go and have fun. Not that we weren't having fun before, but we're going to have a more... whoa, that's a freaky outfit. That, thank you. Thank you. Thanks very much for getting involved. And thank you to Louis on camera and Catherine on supervision. And we're going to now go and get ourselves freaked out. I've got to join the rainbow and become the colour green. Well, that's not easy enough. I need some green face paint, though. And that's it. Thanks very much. Check out thepeoplespeak.org.uk. I've got some cards somewhere, but I've kind of lost them. So you just have to look it up. But you can see this on the internet. Are they over there? No. Okay. Thanks very much.